I'm Kentucky State Police Sergeant Billy Gregory, Public Affairs Commander. On Sunday, May 30th, 2021, the Louisville Metro Police Department requested the Kentucky State Police Critical Incident Response Team to respond to an officer-involved shooting, as we do for law enforcement agencies across the Commonwealth. As of today, initial interviews of some critical witnesses have been completed, and KSP is releasing the body cam footage as obtained from LMPD. Our agency is committed to responsible transparency over immediacy to ensure every investigation is conducted with honesty, integrity, and strong moral and ethical principles. We encourage everyone to remember this video is only one piece of evidence, and the totality of every piece of evidence should be considered without exception during all investigations. On Sunday, May 30th, 2021, at approximately 9:40 a.m., officers from LMPD's 4th Division were conducting an investigation on a stolen vehicle in the area of Georgetown Place and Conn Alley. Two adult males fled from the vehicle, with the officers pursuing on foot and locating one of the subjects, 32-year-old Ryan A. Bernal, in the 3600 block of Georgetown. Based on body cam footage captured from Officer Brenton Woodford's body cam, the subject brandishes a firearm and places it to the area of his neck and face while backing away from officers. Officers give repeated loud verbal instruction to Bernal to drop his weapon. Bernal disregards the instruction and raises the weapon and points it at officers. At this time, LMPD Officer Brenton Woodford, a 5-year veteran of LMPD, discharges his agency-issued weapon. A second body cam video obtained from LMPD Officer Chase Barrett, serving since February 2021, giving a physical description and discharging his agency-issued weapon. At one point during the incident, Officer Barrett's body cam becomes dislodged but is quickly reattached, and Bernal is seen being struck from Officer Woodford's video and falling to the ground. Both videos conclude with officers securing Bernal for officer safety reasons, rendering medical aid, and calling for emergency medical services. Bernal was transported to University Hospital, where he later died. An autopsy was performed at the State Medical Examiner's Office, and results are pending. Please be advised that what you are about to view contains graphic material and may not be suitable for some people.
Drop it! Get back! Drop it!